Cambodia has an interesting geography. It is in southeastern Asia and bordering the Gulf of Thailand. It is also between Thailand, Vietnam, and Laos. The terrain is mostly flat, low plains, and the mountains are in the southwest and north area of Cambodia. The climate is tropical and rainy, and monsoon season is May to November. Dry season is December to April. Some of the natural resources are oil, gas, timber, gemstones, some iron ore, and phosphates. The blue color of the Cambodian flag symbolizes the country's royalty. The red represents the nation, and the white represents the religion, the current major religion, Buddhism. The emblem of the temple represents the structure of the universe. The temples of Angkor Wat were built by the Khmer civilization between 802 and 1220 AD. In Angkor Wat, there are 108 towers. The number 108 is considered sacred in both Hindu and Buddhist cosmologies. It is the sum of 72 plus 36, 36 being half of 72. Angkor Wat was built during the early years of the 12th century. It honors the Hindu gods Vishnu and is a symbol representative of Hindu cosmology. Archaeologists sometimes interpret the temples of Angkor Wat as complex structures, yet in reality, those kings designed and constructed the temples as a form of service to both gods and their own subjects. The temples were places not for worship of the kings, but rather for the worship of gods. During the half millennium of the Khmer occupation, the city of Angkor Wat became a pilgrimage destination of importance throughout Southeast Asia, sacked by the Thais in 1431 and abandoned in 1432. Angkor Wat was forgotten for a few centuries. Wandering Buddhist monks passed through the dense jungles, occasionally came upon the awesome ruins, recognized the sacred nature of the temples, but ignorant of their origins, they invented fables about the mysterious sanctuaries, saying they had been built by the gods in a far ancient time. In Cambodia, Vietnamese make up the largest minority group with about 5% of the population, and the Chinese make up another 1%. With one of the highest population growth rates in Asia, Cambodia had a population of a little over 1 million in 1998. The time of the Khmer Rouge was a very sad time for Cambodia. The people were killed and forced out of their homes. A lot of skulls and bones were left in the killing fields for people to see and remember the sad time of Cambodia. The glittering costumes worn today by Cambodian dancers resemble Thai robes and crowns, emphasizing the odd exchange between Cambodia and Thailand that came as a result of the Thai conquest of Angkor Wat 5 centuries ago. The people of Cambodia were kept in prisons and then were taken to places to be terminated by kids and young adults. Cambodian dance can be divided into three broad categories. The first category took birth in the royal courts and is known as classical dancing. Then there are the folk dances that serve as storytelling performances of the everyday life. The vernacular dances are the third category. They are prepared and reserved for special occasions. The traditional Khmer costume consists of a shirt or blouse and a skirt-like lower garment, sampot, for women and sarong for men. Made of cotton or of silk in many different styles and patterns, it is pulled over the legs and fastened around the waist. On ceremonial occasions like weddings, elegant sampot or sarongs embroidered with gold or silver threads may be worn with a long piece of material gathered at the waist, passed between legs, and tucked into the waistband in the back. Pol Pot was a leader in the Cambodian communist movement. Pol Pot's reform policies drove many people from major cities and forced tens of thousands into labor. Pol Pot denied many Cambodians food and medical care, and the mass killings of all suspected opponents. Pol Pot was responsible for the deaths of over 1 million Cambodians, nearly 20% of the country's total population. The Nutrition Center Orphanage is located in Phnom Penh. 120 children, mainly under the age of 5, are there. About 30% of these children are HIV positive. Because they are in a poor financial state, the caretakers have a lack of time and skills needed to sustain a healthy living for the children. During the duration of 2002 through 2008, the orphanage development project was carried out. They wanted to help improve one of the biggest orphanages in Phnom Penh. The project was able to improve the living conditions and meet the needs of the orphanage.